In the years prior to June 25th, 1938, the United States was a nation where millions of children, some as young as 5, worked up to 18 hours a day. Employers paid workers as little as possible, in some cases as low as a dollar per day, and faced no federal or state regulations. This all changed when President Franklin Delano Roosevelt signed the Fair Labor Standards Act, the FLSA, into law on that day.
The law had a long road to passage. For years, states battled with the Supreme Court for laws to protect the workers, whereas the Supreme Court would invariably favor the rights of private corporations, arguing that government had no place intruding in the economic liberty of its citizens. The fight to prohibit child labor and the struggle for the 8-hour day had many champions and lasted most of a century, including many significant strikes and acts of violence of protest against the government. But it took the Great Depression for the opportunity to arise for an emboldened and progressive government to make changes for its people. With workers working fewer hours, employers could hire more workers, alleviating the mass unemployment at the times. FDR's landslide victory in the 1936 election and Democratic gains in Congress gave him the mandate to pursue the ambitious and far-reaching programs of the New Deal, from Social Security to low-cost public housing provisions and the FLSA.
The FLSA guaranteed a minimum hourly wage, maximum weekly hours, overtime pay regulations, and prohibited employment of minors outright. From its humble beginnings of a guaranteed 25 cents an hour to $7.25 today, and the push for $15 an hour in the future, the FLSA is the building block of workers' rights in America.